to turn off some LED lights on one of the boxes I was building. I needed to control them. And so I bought this relay, but these only lasted about a month and they failed. So I decided to make my own because I didn't need anything really that fancy. I just need to control it with 12 volts. So I found these relays here and just gonna make my own. Mini breadboard. So kind of like this. Control one side of the relay. It's a double pull, double throw relay. So let's look at how this relay works. There's a diagram on it. It's showing you this end is the coil here. So you apply voltage to this end here. And then these are your switches over here. So that's your common in the middle. And so right now, the middle one and the one on the end here are closed. Okay, so if we put our meter up here, then we apply voltage to the coil. Then the relay energizes and moves the switch inside. So these rows are all connected. This row here, it's not connected to here. Okay, just across here are connected. You can see that. Okay, but if I go to this side here, it doesn't tone. Across here, and then nothing else is gonna tone across here. Just across these. So we're going to put the coil on the end here and then on this end here. So we can put these on this end, and that's what we're going to use to control the coils. So we have everything placed here. We'll flip it over. So then, here and here is the coil. Here and here is the coil. And then you can see these line up in this row. Right, so we can hook wires up here. And they line up with the relay here. Across like that. Now we're just gonna solder these in place. Then to feed the other side, the other coil here, I'm just gonna use a wire and jump it over to here. We can test from anything on that row. Over there, we should get to. There. So now what we've done is we've extended the relay out to these other posts. So like this common on the relay is now over to here. Right, giving us somewhere to now connect wiring. So sitting in the non-energized state, the post closest to the coils are on the end, opposite ends, is gonna be the common. So the one next to it is the one that's closed right now. All right, so this one's open. And then we'll energize it and I'll show you what happens. Okay, so now energized, your common's here, and now our closed circuit is there. So this is the common. It's open, it's closed. So common on this side, common on this side. So it's going to feed negative across to here, and then negative across to here. So we're feeding the coils on both of those with the negative. What we'll do is we'll put a LED light here. That's our common. Positive here, this one will have positive. And when we energize the relay, then this side will get positive and this will open. We're going to demonstrate that here with two LED lights. And then we need a positive wire. I'm going to use this switch here so we can switch everything on and off. One state, the relay's got that one lit, and then the other state has that one lit. So what I'm using this for is when I have power switched on one of the switches, it opens my LED circuit because I don't want my LEDs to light in that particular mode.